racked with pain, and your health you can't regain. Bring your needs to Jesus, take them to the Lord in prayer. Whatsoever you shall say will be yours when you ask in faith. Put a name on your need and claim it in Jesus' name.
Well, bless that wonderful name of Jesus. I pray that you put a name and claim it in Jesus' name on your blessing. Believe it and receive it in Jesus' name. We give honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who is our life. In Him we live, we move, and we have our being. With Him all things are possible, and yet without Him we could do nothing. So we thank God for that wonderful name of Jesus. We give honor to God, and we thank God for you tuning in to another broadcast of The Word Ministries, hosted to you by yours truly. I am Pastor Billy Bedford, and we thank God for you tuning in to this broadcast today. If you happen to be on your way out the door, we pray God's blessings upon you, and you can get this same ministries this afternoon at 5:30 p.m. So tune in if you happen to be going out the door right now to your local church. We do encourage you to go to your church, Bible-believing church, amen, and hear the word of God. Amen. God bless you and God keep you. We thank God for all of our viewers, those that are shut in and are not able to get out. We thank God for this avenue that is able to bring the word to you right in your living room. And I thank God for all of our viewers, and we thank God for the station here at WRL TV 47. If you're viewing in, we're thankful and grateful. Give them a call and let them know that they're doing a great job. Great blessings come, amen, from this broadcast, and we're thankful and grateful, giving honor to, amen, Sister Elizabeth that watches every Sunday, Sister Strickland, Mother Ann Gilliland, all of those in the areas that watch, and also our YouTube viewers. We thank God, amen, for you, and thank God for all of His many blessings. We want to go in prayer. The Bible says, where two or three are gathered together in my name, touching and agreeing, there am I in the midst. So I come today to pray in agreement with you. Amen. Don't know what you need right now, but I know prayer changes things. The Bible says that man always ought to pray and not faint, and that we should pray without ceasing. A key element to prayer is that the Bible says that the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. So, amen, when we're right in connection with God, amen, and we've given our life to God, God not only hear prayer, but God answers prayer. He said, when you call me, then will I answer. When you cry, I will say, here I am. He told us that we could ask and it shall be given, that we could seek and find and knock and the door shall be opened unto us. So we're going to go in prayer today. The Bible says, with prayer and supplication, let us make our requests known unto God. That's what Grandmama was talking about when she said, Jesus is on the main line. You just call Him up and tell Him what you want. If you want your soul saved, call Him up and tell Him what you want. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. If you want your body healed, call Him up and tell Him what you want. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon Him, and with His stripes we are healed. If you just need a way made, call Him up and tell Him what you want. Philippians 4:19 says that our God shall supply all of our need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Glory to God. Let us go to the throne of grace in prayer. Amen. Believing, amen, that we shall receive. Father God in heaven, we come to say thank you, Lord, for your goodness, for your manifold blessings. We thank you, Lord, for this day that you have made. We shall rejoice and be glad therein. We thank you for these, your people. Some need one thing and some need another. Some need their souls saved. Some need healing for their body. Some just need a way made. But Lord God, you are the way, the truth, and the life. You are, God, the door of the sheep, and by you, if any man enter, he shall be saved. We thank you right now. We pray in agreement for those that are needing their souls saved. God, I touch from you. We ask that you touch hearts and touch minds, that someone will come running and saying, I yield. What must I do to be saved? We pray for that one that is in the hospital, one that is on the bed of affliction. God, we declare and decree and we touch an agreement that by your stripes we are healed. We pray that you touch bodies right now from the crown of their head to the very sole of their feet. God, you're able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think according to the power that work in us. I pray, God, for healing. I pray for deliverance right now. I pray, God, that the word goes forth, Lord, with power and demonstration of the Holy Ghost. I pray, God, that it fall on good ground. Let the seed fall on good ground. In the name of Jesus, I pray healing. I pray salvation. I pray deliverance. And I believe it in your name. Father, we thank you and we love you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And thank God. Amen. Also, amen, on next Sunday at this same time, amen, Elder Evangelist Yolanda Patterson, amen, will be here, amen, to preach the word of God. So, amen, we want you to tune in on next Sunday at this same time. Amen. She's also the author of a book, amen, The Woman's Eve Syndrome. And I learned and I read the book, amen, it's just not for females, but there's a lot in the book, amen. If you're going through, if you've ever been through something in your past, something in your present, or something maybe in your future, amen, this book, amen, will certainly help you, and it can be purchased, amen, in other ways. So we thank God. She's going to be here on next Sunday, amen, bringing the word of God. Psalm 37, amen. And we're going to begin at verse 1 from Psalm 37. Praise the name of God. And now you will find these words recorded. Fret not thyself because of either evildoers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good, and so shalt thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Commit thy way unto the Lord. Trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass. And he shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and thy judgment as the noonday. Rest in the Lord, and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. Cease from anger and forsake wrath. Fret not thyself in any wise to do evil, for evildoers shall be cut off. But those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. Fret not thyself because of evildoers, verse 1 says, neither be thou envious of workers of iniquity. Verse 7 says, in the latter portion of it, says, fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. Amen. The latter portion of verse 8 says, fret not thyself in any wise to do evil. We want to take a subject today dealing with fret. Don't fret it. Don't sweat it. Give it to Jesus and you won't regret it. Don't fret it. Don't sweat it. Give it to Jesus, and you won't regret it. A subject matter is centered around fret, sweat, and regret. From the study of the Word of God and from experiences in my own life, let me be the first to say, things that you go through in life that causes fret, causes sweat, causes regret, amen. As I'm telling you, don't fret it, don't sweat it, don't give it to Jesus, and you won't regret it. Let me be the first to say that that's easier said than done. Praise the name of God. It is only through giving it to Jesus can you go through this life, amen, not fretting the trials and the troubles that we face in life. Situation that has happened to us, praise the name of God, causes many to fret, causes many to sweat, and causes many to regret. Amen. And the only way through that I've learned from experience is to give it to Jesus. Praise the name of God. And when you give it to Jesus, you won't regret it. If your back is against the wall and there's no one to call, don't fret it. Don't sweat it. Give it to Jesus and you won't regret it. If you're going through storms and rain and heartache and pain, amen, I encourage you today, don't fret it. Don't sweat it. Give it to Jesus and you won't regret it. If your money is funny and if your change is strange, if your credit can't get it, I encourage you today, don't fret it. Don't sweat it. Give it to Jesus and you won't regret it. As I speak right now, there are many, and amen, and I dare say there are many in the body of Christ. There are many in the local churches, praise the name of God, that fret, they sweat, and they regret. Amen. Perhaps you've thought it if you haven't said it. Many of us, amen, look back over some things in our life, and amen, if you haven't said it, perhaps you've thought it. If I could turn back the hands of time, praise the name of God, there are decisions that we make in life that causes fret, that causes sweat, that causes regret. Well, since we can't change the past, praise the name of God, amen, what we have to do is give it to Jesus. Praise his holy name. And as I look back, and my question would be today is, why are so many fretting if you say don't fret? Why are so many sweating if you say don't sweat it? Why are so many regretting if you say don't give it to Jesus and you won't regret it? Why, brother pastor? Well, there are reasons as to why we fret, we sweat, and we regret. And one of the main reasons is that we don't totally give it over to Jesus. Grandmama said, bring your burdens to the Lord. Bring your burdens to the altar. And Grandmama left a very important part on the end. She said, leave them there. Praise the name of God. I've been guilty. Perhaps you've been guilty. You've taken your situation, your circumstance, amen, what you're going through, you've taken it to the Lord, amen. But did you fully give it over to him? I declare today, amen, when you give it to Jesus, praise the name of God, yes, you may cry, but I got good news for you. They that sow in tears shall reap in joy. Glory to God. Weeping may endure but a night, but joy is coming in the morning. That is when you give it to Jesus. Many, amen, fret, sweat, and regret, amen, praise the name of God, comes from the lack of knowledge. The Bible says, my people perish for the lack of knowledge. Glory to God. We fret coming from the lack of understanding. We must come to an understanding that no matter the road, no matter how hard it seems, Jesus is going to take care of it. Somebody said that the battle is not yours, but it belongs to the Lord. Vengeance is mine, saith God. I will repay. Praise the name of God. You know what that does? That keeps me from fretting, knowing that he's going to take care of the situation. Knowing, amen, praise the name of God, that he, amen, his eyes are over the righteous. His eyes are in every place. Praise the name of God. He see what you're going through. He know what you've been through. Praise the name of God. But don't fret it. Don't sweat it. Give it to Jesus and you won't regret it. We fret from the lack of faith. The Bible says, amen, praise the name of God, that without faith it is impossible to please God. Amen. Praise the name of God. We fret. Amen. Do we believe that God can get us through? Do we believe, amen, that he's the author and finisher of our faith? Do we really believe that he which has begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ? Do we really believe that no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper? Do we really believe that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world? Do we really believe that when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift up a standard against them? Do we really believe he's a healer? Do we really believe he's a way out of no way? Do we really believe he's a burden bearer and a heavy load sharer? Amen. We have to have faith. Amen, to keep from fretting. We have to have faith to keep from sweating. We have to have faith to keep from regretting. Amen, the Bible says, amen, he that cometh to me, praise the name of God, must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. You got to have faith. You may say today, I don't have a whole lot. Amen, what do you say to that? I say, you don't have to have a whole lot. Just use the little you got. Now, for Mark 11:22 says, if you have faith as a grain of mustard seed, you can speak to mountains and tell mountains to move and go yonder plain. I decided in my mind, amen, why fret it when I can give it to Jesus? Why am I sweating so? Why am I down? Why am I downtrodden? I serve a God that is able. If I could call up a witness today, I will show you three men that never fretted. Amen, praise God. Amen, glory to God. When King Nebuchadnezzar had made a decree, everybody got to bow down at the music, at the sound of the harp, the flute, the dulcimer. Praise the name of God, but there were three men that did not fret it, that did not sweat it, and they did not regret it. And they came to the three men and said, is it true that you're not going to bow? They said to him, we are not careful to answer you concerning this matter. For the God we serve, he's able. How many know he's able today? Has he ever brought you through when the doctor shook his head? But Jesus brought you through. Have the money never lined up with your bank account, but Jesus let you got through it. You never lost a meal, never unpaid a bill. Jesus will take care of it. Glory to God. They threw me in the fiery furnace.
in, hallelujah. But when they looked back in, he went back to the counselor and said, counselor, did not we put in three? But he said, I see four men walking around loose in the midst of the fire. They not fretting, they're not sweating, they're not regretting, but they walking around loose. I don't smell their hair, I don't smell their clothes. God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we ask, all that we think. We fret, we sweat, we regret, but if we give it to Jesus, he said, cast all of your care upon him, for he cares for you. The load may be heavy, burden seem hard to bear, it's causing you to fret, it's causing you to sweat, it's causing you to regret. What do I do? What you need to do? Jesus said, come unto me, all that labor, all that are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, learn of me, I'm meek, I'm lowly in heart, I'll give you rest unto your soul. The writer today, he said, fret not yourself because of evildoing. I stopped by today to tell you, a lot of people look for the devil in a red suit with a long tail and a pitchfork. But I stopped by today to tell you, the devil works in many disguises. He can wear a suit. As a matter of fact, the Bible said he has false prophets that come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly are raving in wolves. Even the Bible says that the devil has transformed himself into a minister of light. But I want to tell you today, don't fret it, don't sweat it, give it to Jesus, and you won't regret it. The writer today said, fret not yourself because of evildoers. You got evildoers in the land. I don't know. You may have some in your family. You may have some in the church. What do I do? You don't fret it. Hallelujah. You can't worry about it. You give it to Jesus. Don't be envious of workers of iniquity. There was one writer in the Bible. He said, my foot almost slipped looking at the prosperity of the wicked. You fast, you pray, you live holy. Seems like the demons are on your back. Seems like the one in the world. They smiling, they got money, they got fine houses, but that's all right. Don't fret it, don't sweat it. The very one that do you wrong, walking around with a smile on their face, don't fret it, don't sweat it, give it to Jesus, you won't regret it. The Bible said, be not deceived, God is not mocked, whatever man sows, that shall he also reap. Don't worry about it. Verse 2, it says, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass. Touch not my anointed, do my prophet no harm. They're going to soon be cut down like the grass and wither as a green herb. What do I do? In the meantime, instead of fretting, instead of sweating, instead of regretting, verse 3 says, trust in the Lord.
when you're going through your battles, your sickness, your financial difficulty, on top of all of that, there are evildoers. Praise the name of God. Evildoers that's trying to cause you to fret. Figuring if you fret, you'll give up. Figuring if you sweat, you'll give in. Verse 3 says, trust in the Lord. Notice it did not say in the system. It didn't say trust in man. Not even in yourself. Trust in the Lord. I'm confident that Abraham trusted in the Lord when he took his own one son up the mountain and took out the sword to slay his son. And God said, Abraham, Abraham, stay your hand. Hallelujah, there is a ram in the bush. Trust in the Lord and do good, and so shall thou dwell in the land, and verily you shall be fed. David said, I was young, but now am old. Yet have I never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. That's why I don't regret giving it to Jesus. Regardless of what I go through, I give it to Jesus. Praise the name of God. And now you out there, if anyone heard your testimony, they would wonder, how do you still smile? How do you still keep going? Reason being, you trust in the Lord and you continue to do good. When you're overlooked, left out, looked down on, do good. Kindness taken for weakness. Trust in the Lord and do good. Praise the name of God. Let us not be weary in well-doing. In due season, we shall reap if we faint not. Delight yourself also in the Lord. The Greek Hebrew word for that delight is to do that what brings pleasure to God. That's how you delight yourself in Him. Do that which brings pleasure to God. Can't you hear God saying, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. Did you not know that when a man's ways please the Lord, guess what he'll do? He'll make even his enemies to be at peace with him. David said he'll prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. May God bless you. May God keep you. Don't fret it. Don't sweat it. Give it to Jesus and you won't regret it.